Welcome, Chris Williams. Welcome to the show. Finally.
What's up, guys? We are back on Tim Westwood Live, back in North London, ready for another podcast. You ready?
I've heard of him now.
What's up, Trailer Gang? What's up, Trailer Gang?
What's up, Trailer Gang?
Trailer Gang,
welcome back to another podcast.
Salim, like, I've admired you for a long time, and thank you for coming on. I've seen you since, like, middle school. You haven't changed your shit. I've been making, like, videos since middle school. I changed my shit for, like, what I think people like. Mm-hmm. You haven't. You've been making the same stuff every single day. So I just want to say thank you for coming on the show. Yeah, I think we're all really big fans. Way more than, I don't know. We've had a lot of creators on, and they remind us of certain people, yeah, of certain creators that have come before us that we've watched. You don't remind me of anyone that I've ever seen. It's sick. So, yeah, thank you.
Thank you for having me.
No, yeah, you're your own breed of fucking of YouTube creator. It's like, because I haven't really seen anything else like it. I mean, like, besides, like, the, you know, like, Nelk pranks and stuff. But now you're part of that. So, like, how did your, I guess, like, how did you, like, I guess, like, get into Nelk? Get, I don't know, like, how does that even work?
I'll tell you the story exactly. So, Kyle hit me up. If you guys don't know Kyle. Kyle's from Nelk. You guys know.
Yeah, we know Kyle.
Yeah, so he hit me up about a year ago around Coachella area. Okay. And I've been watching Nelk for so long. Like, I'm, like, a huge Nelk fan. Even before, like, I love Nelk. And when he hit me up, I was like, what the fuck is going on? That's when I was, like, really, really pushing hard on, like, the stuff that I make. Because I was getting views and stuff, right?
Yeah.
Everything was going good. But after that, that made me think, oh, my fucking God.
How many followers, like, did you have at that point?
I was at, like, 500K.
Okay.
400K.
So you're still, Insta? You're still, like, popping low-key.
Yeah,
I mean, no, I don't know.
I've seen your shit, like, on, like, before, like, Nelk. Like, yeah, it was on, like, Barstool, like, Full Set. Or, not even Full Set, but, like, Barstool.
Total Frat Move.
Total Frat Move, all that stuff.
Yeah. I mean, I was doing a lot of pranks, but I was like, how am I? Because I wasn't making money off Instagram. And I was like, you know, when you're, like, getting a lot of views, it's just, like, so, like, nice. You're like, fuck it. Fuck the money, you know? Yeah. In my head, I was thinking that. I was like, fuck.
But after a little bit, it's like, just, where's the money?
Yeah, that's when it starts. For sure. Yeah. So, yeah, he hit me up, and then I hit him back up. It was Kyle that was hitting me up on the Nelk Boys page. I hit him back up, and he told me to come to the Cloud House when they were living there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
at the phase,
the now hype house and shit. Yeah,
yeah, the now hype house. So I went over there and I was just like, wow. Like, I came upstairs on the elevator, and he was like just the whole system was just like, what the hell? This is like another level, because they had like editors on the long, you know, the long table on the upstairs, yeah, like where the balcony is. They just had a whole system, and I was like, dude, this is like,
it's like a business.
It's a business. Yeah, I didn't think it was though.
Yeah,
I didn't think it was. But the way they were getting views and just how they structure their videos in a way, like the titling, like, it comes down to all that shit. That's what I really admire too when I first came there.
So they're studying shit before they title something.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like, they know how to title a video. They like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That I looked at Kyle and I was like, this dude is like a smart ass dude. Yeah. I met Kyle that day. I didn't meet Jesse that day. But when I met Kyle, he was like, yeah, let's do a video, like an Instagram vid or whatever. And then
they've been doing that for so long.
This is a long Jesse time.
Yes.
Like, how many? Yeah, and I can't remember the first. What was it? Was like a trio that started it, right?
It was a trio. It was Kyle, Jesse, and Lucas.
Yeah, the other, like, the editor dude. He would like pop it for like a single video or something.
What do you mean?
Like he was there.
No, it was a trio before, like a while back though. It was like years ago. And then he didn't want to do from what I know, he didn't want to do YouTube no more. And he wasn't really about the whole, like, traveling aspect of it and stuff. Yeah. So he didn't want to do it, and he had other dreams to, you know, fulfill. So it was just Kyle and Jesse from there. And then Kyle, Jesse, all the way to Steve. They got Steve. And then a year later, like, from the Coachella, Steve wasn't there. Like, was it last year? Yeah, it was last year.
Yeah, it had to be, yeah.
So, yeah, he wasn't there. We didn't even do the video then. I hit him up. I forgot to hit him up. Not going to lie. I forgot to hit him up because...
you forgot to respond to him?
Not respond. I DM'd him back. I was like, yo, let's do a video this time or whatever, right?
Yeah.
And he had hit me back up like 3 days later. So I was already doing something because I didn't know what was going to happen. So it led from there to all the way like to December after the Europe tour. After the Europe tour, he hit me up. He was like, "Yo, let's fucking do a video." We did a sneezing video. It was like
that was pre-COVID.
It was yeah. Pre-COVID. It was the guy that that was like fighting with me with the spray bottle.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. No, that guy.
Dude, that shit was so funny.
So yeah, Kyle did when I did one. It did so well on each page, and then we started working more together about like just videos and all that. So yeah, it's been great.
That's really great. Fucking awesome.
So you and Jay were living in a car at that point, right?
Yes.
Right, because I remember the video. I can't remember if you guys came to the house and you guys were like moving in. You guys moving shit in like trash.
I didn't
bag.
Know we were gonna move in. Yeah. I was like, dude, I was telling Jay, I was like, bro, we have to move in. I was like, dude, we have to move in. Yeah. Like no matter what, and it seemed like it was like that type of vibe because we had a good like we filmed the whole video together, like the whole sneezing prank, and then we met up again for like. An upcoming vaping in people's faces.
We did that one. Vaping aggressively in people's faces.
Yeah, vaping aggressively in people's faces.
Oh, did that one the guy titling. Like, what did you do? What did you just do?
Yeah, that
like
guy.
8 times?
So that is when I was like, okay, this vibe seems right. If we fucked up, we fucked up. But that was like the... As soon as he said, yo, you guys can move in, I was like, oh, yeah, we're good. We're about to kill
him. So what you're saying earlier about Colin, like when you first went to the former Cloud House, like what I've learned from like all the people that we've had on is there's a lot of people who can flip that switch. They're business minded, but they're also like funny as fuck, and they send it.
Yeah,
is that Kyle? Like he's
dude,
kinda,
he is
he's businessman,
a genius.
That's sick. Okay,
like seriously, he really is a genius. I think that's why we connect so well too. It's
because you're so smart. You're so
come on, bro.
I mean, we're both D-bags, but yeah. At the same time, like
you're thinking business too.
Yeah. Well, with like strategy of like just posting videos, like when to post. How to post, like this, that, like we understood social media,
yeah,
like on the same level in a way.
I mean, so, you guys can't be the size you are and like do the crazy shit you are without somebody leading like Kyle, who's thinking like both content's funny as fuck, but also this is what we need to do to be successful money wise, so that we can reinvest in ourselves.
Guy's
you guys spend your
guy's
money on
genius.
Yourself.
Yeah, he's I don't know, he's something else.
Well, because Nelk doesn't make any money off YouTube, right?
Straight merch. Dude.
Yeah,
straight
so merch. I mean,
and just to maintain that you see how hard that is? Like that's like I don't know. Yeah. I don't know anyone else that can do that. That's different.
Yeah, and also what I've noticed, you and Kyle have a particular chemistry. Like the video that stands out to me, I've watched a lot of Nelk videos, and it's the you guys Lids Bigfoot prank.
Oh yeah.
That shit was the funniest
Rafiki!
That shit was the funniest crazy. Fucking
that,
video I've ever seen.
That shit's
like,
so funny.
I don't know, I've always wanted to know like the behind the scenes that like how you guys actually make that happen. Like what was because you guys were doing your tour across the United States. Like, what was that even like?
Just to give context to the audience who might like not, because we have a lot of different audiences. Like, they tricked this like Sasquatch hunter guide to thinking that they were looking for Bigfoot, and then fucking Salim dresses up as like okay.
He was a mute character.
He was a mute character.
We were in the Sprinter, and Kyle was like, yo. We should do a deaf part. I think someone should play a deaf part or some shit. And then I was like, fuck it, I'll do it. And he was like, what should your name be like? Like Rafiki or something? He literally said that. I was like, fuck it, yeah, let's do it. Because I'm going into a prank. I'm like, okay, I don't know nothing about Sasquatch, first of all. I don't know what to do. So let me just fucking not talk, basically. I was like, just shut the fuck up and just be this African savior or some shit or survivor.
Yeah.
So I go in. And I'm deaf. I'm glad I played well because I didn't know I did. Like,
it was fucking hilarious.
When I went from getting fucked, not going to say it, but getting fucked by a Bigfoot. Right? Yeah. And then having to, I didn't know if I played that. I didn't know if he knew.
Did you yell like he fucked me in the ass?
No. So he like,
I was just moaning.
So he like went off into like the woods and the tour guide's
dead serious. He thinks this is real.
Yeah. He was like looking like, right. Like he's like,
he
he's
believed like, it. I was like, dude,
he's like,
this
he's
insane.
Like, there's a Bigfoot in there. He's like, there's a Bigfoot near, he was saying, what was he saying? He was like upright, tall, hairy.
Yeah.
He was like referring to like proper nomenclature and he, and then Rafiki or Salim comes back, and he's like saying in like semi-sign language,
he fucked me in the ass.
Yeah. And then he was trying to get the Bigfoot expert to go get fucked in the ass.
He was like, no. no, I'm not doing it.
He's like, I'm not doing it. No matter how much. He was saying that'd be cheating, right? And then Kyle was like, it's not cheating if it's Bigfoot.
Bigfoot fucks you, so you're cheating on your wife?
No. That's exactly what he was saying. And this guy was so into it. Like, he was so into it. Like, he believed it was real Bigfoot. Who is just as Bigfoot?
It's our assistant. His name's Jazz. Like Jazz Hands. Mm-hmm. Jazz Hands.
And he's called Jazz Hands. And so he was dressed as Bigfoot. So have you guys heard from that guy, the Bigfoot tour guide, since the prank?
I'll tell you something. His buddy that, I don't know if you remember, but Kyle was talking shit to him when we were looking at all the like pieces that he had around his garage or some shit. And he was, what had happened? He was talking about somebody that he didn't like. Like the Sasquatch guy, like he was like saying, oh, I don't know if his sources are not that good. I don't think he's seen it or whatever, right? That same guy tweeted out saying, like, the guy's name, and he was like, this Bigfoot guy, we're going to call him Bigfoot guy. He was like, got tricked, haha, don't talk shit about me, or some shit like that. He tweeted that. The guy that we were talking about tweeted that, and
so you guys are starting beef in the Bigfoot Sasquatch world. In the Sasquatch world of Twitter.
Yeah, they're meeting in like random cafes, like talking shit about Nelk.
Yeah, well, like fuck you, you fucking Bigfoot hunter,
dude. I thought Sasquatch fucked him.
His name is Cliff.
He was a good sport about it, though. Well, actually, no, he wasn't.
He was scaring me, bro. When we were skirting out of there, I was like, dude, I don't think we're going to go out alive. We're in the woods.
That's my favorite part of your videos, is the part when you realize, we got to get the fuck out of here. Like, when you went on that wine tasting tour in Italy, and you just, like, jumped in the van, that's the best part, when you're, like, trying to make sure no one's chasing after you.
Yeah, no, you guys have gotten in some shitty situations.
Yeah.
What's your top shitty situation that you've been in? I feel like it was that one time. You guys had to dip from the hotel really quick, right?
Oh, we were in the Keys.
Yeah, that one
was really scary. I didn't expect that to happen, though. It seemed like the guy didn't, like, we're literally filming, Jay's filming, and we're doing hitting on girlfriends in front of their boyfriends.
Yeah.
And I hit on this guy's wife, but I wasn't even pranking him. He thought he was filming like his daughter's like behind or some shit. And he got very, very pissed, and he was like, yo, you want to know how we do it in the Keys? You've seen it before, but...
Yeah, and he showed the video to Steve, and it was like two people...
No, he showed the security guard. He was like...
Dude's like body bagged.
And we're like, fuck no, we're not dealing with this, especially like some of you don't know.
Yeah.
So we like skirted out of there quick.
No, you guys got out of there fast. Like everybody was throwing shit off the balcony and stuff. So what's number two then? Like of just like sketchiest Nelk moments. Like when you get into something that's just like... It like flips from like, oh, this is fun, to like, this is fucked up. We got to get the fuck out of here.
When Kyle got hit, our first video we did together, he got hit.
Was that like, was that sneezing?
Sneezing. He got hit in the face. Yeah, this guy, he hit him in the face, and he was like, he called his boys. He was like, yo.
That guy's hood as fuck.
He's like, come up here. I was like, really, like, get out of here now.
Yeah.
I was like running. You know what I mean? Fuck. And that was a scary moment. We had to meet at a parking lot.
Yeah. So did you guys make up with that guy later?
We did.
And he was cool, right?
He was cool. Kyle and him were cool. I don't know how that happened. But
I feel like Kyle's just like that.
I don't know. He's a likable guy. Yeah. He's a likable guy. But I guess he met up with him to fuck with me when I did a Walmart video. And he was like, let's go do a video. And then the guy was there. I was like, dude, this is him. And then I was going to do it.
You were freaking out too.
He seen me. I was like, fuck no, we're out of here. And they were so slow to the car. Everyone was so slow. So
he
was a
big dude too. So like he couldn't like actually like catch up to you.
I was like, bro, I got to run for my life. Yeah. This guy gets me. Damn. And I was running. You know when you're huffing and puffing? It's like,
We got to go into like a ton of these kind of behind the scenes stuff. I do kind of want to bring it back a little bit and hear about like, I mean, I don't know. Like what we've been doing recently with, you know, meeting people that we've watched before all the time. It's been crazy because we're living like what we've seen for the entire time. Like, what is your kind of growing up? Did you watch videos like the Pranksters? You know, I mean, even like
Vitaly,
bro, streaking out the World Cup. That shit was funny as fuck. Yeah. Who'd you grow up with, and like what's kind of the story behind like entering this world, like the crazy ass shit we do?
The Nelk Boys. I've watched Vitaly. I mean, whatever. You ever heard of Whatever?
No,
they're very clever. Whatever is really dope. I like Whatever.
Royal Stampede, have you heard of them?
I've heard of them, yeah. I've watched a couple of their videos, but I'm not like, I didn't watch them like that. I watched Roman Outlet and stuff.
Oh, he was funny as fuck.
Yeah, but I mean, as the time went on,
his pranks are like, oh yeah, I just killed my kids in front of my wife.
Yeah. Check my it wife out. Saw my kid blow up.
I just fucking threw my kid off the stairs.
Yeah.
And watched him die in front of my wife. It's like he just his videos just make. I don't know. I've never gotten
it's like
that.
The level of like the Kobe person pranks. Remember that?
You know what I mean? Yeah, I don't yeah. want to talk about that guy.
Fuck Kobe person.
Bro. They, well, who is that?
Like, or nah. Joey Salads? Come on, Joey Salads.
I don't know
bro.
About that guy too.
Yeah. It's like the classic is like the gold digger prank where it's yeah. like they like pull.
Hey, he fooled me though. He fooled me.
You thought it was real?
I thought I was like, yo, this guy. No, everyone's crazy.
They literally just go into their Instagram DMs, find one hot girl. They're like, yo, pull up for 5 minutes and we'll film this prank. And they're oh, like, is dude, that your yeah. Lamborghini? And dude. Then it's just like, the
get in,
stupidest yeah, shit.
So it is very hard to film now, though.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, I am like, I haven't posted in like 20 days almost.
Wait, do you still YouTube? Post on your channel?
No, I post on Instagram mainly, and then I do my
because
shit
your channel
them.
Hasn't been posting like a year, right?
No, I will start though. Yeah. But with that, dude, it's so hard to film my hair. I just hate fucking with people with masks. Like, yeah. It defeats the like. It's like you don't even see the reaction in a way. They yeah. would have to physically have to. You know what I mean? Like,
I think you got an interesting perspective. You're in the team, and people don't see so much like the behind the scenes show. Just show yourself traveling and like doing the pranks. I feel like that would blow the fuck up. I don't know
yeah.
if I'm wrong there.
I mean, that's what we've been doing, and it's like the views are going crazy.
Really? Yeah, yeah, right.
We're in like 6 mil, 5 mil.
Consistently
every
video.
No, well, no, Nelk's ridiculous. Fuck Nelk. Yeah, so you guys are fucking like internet masterminds. I don't yeah. fucking get it. Like yeah. you guys just. Like the hype behind, but I understand it because like I am such a fan of it to like a point to where it's like I love watching this
dude,
shit.
Dude, it goes, there's like, we have a lot of employees.
No, yeah, it's yeah. wild. How many years? What are you guys
like? 29. Like
29?
You guys just upgraded. You guys just upgraded 10, huh?
We think we're big and we got fucking 8.
Yeah, we're trying to figure out how to pay 8 people.
It's literally a system.
How many girls do you guys have on the team?
Yeah.
It's like what? Like 5? It's like 5, right?
4. 3.
So, see, whenever we pull up to somewhere, like, the ratio is just fucked.
Too yeah. many fucking
it's
teams,
so
dude.
Fucked. Yeah. But I feel like you guys don't have that issue. You guys always have heads that pull up with you guys.
Well, what do you mean? Partying?
No, just anywhere. Like, I feel like you guys
yeah.
always have, like,
well,
a
now,
girl
yeah.
entourage, right?
Now, yeah. Now, because, yeah. We like, have assistants with us. Because we have to get shit. We used to, I mean, at least for me, I had to, like, get shit.
You have to go to, like, Walmart and
pick
up random equipment.
Pick up random shit. It's
yeah,
like,
yeah, yeah. Now you have people to do that for you, make sure the prank's set up.
Yeah. Like that they're great. They're great, too. They're great.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I think that's awesome. The goal.
They're dope. They're dope, yeah.
How does a Nelk prank actually come to be? Like, when you guys are...
Like a pre-show plan, like
yeah,
a meeting
like,
or something?
It's like, for us, like we are learning... We are trying to figure out how to vlog, and it is the fucking hardest thing in the world. Like, because the entire day here, everyone's doing something to, like, at least 5.
Really?
Right? Yeah. Like, I mean, like, because... Well,
we
like
wake
these,
up at 7.
These two
we film TikToks right here. Then right after, all the editors get to work, and then Burke and Chris are filming individual like TikTok channels.
Personalities.
We're editing for the YouTube. Then at 5 o'clock, we have a guest, and we're good.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
It's
but
every
so
day.
Like, so like planning to vlog in there, like we don't like leave until like the nighttime. So like, how does a Nelk prank like who comes? Like, is it like different people that come up with it? Like, how does it actually work?
We have a meeting like I think every Tuesday.
Mm-hmm. You think?
No. Well, it's been switching on and off
yeah.
lately, but.
Yeah.
Yeah. Tuesday was the move. So, we would have a meeting. Everyone's there. A production meeting, and we would think of ideas. Like for we have like it's kind of easy thinking of the ideas for the pranks. You know.
Yeah.
But
just because your guys' shit is so like not because I'm just assuming it seems all real.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Right. And it seems like for instance. I don't think that we have the balls to go do something like that. Like, Chris walked into In-N-Out one time.
And he's that was
like,
so cringy.
And he's like, who the fuck made this burger?
He did like that meme.
Yeah, like that one, right? And he's like, who the fuck made this burger? He like walks in. We like weren't even filming. Like, yeah. It was like we forgot
just,
to film or something.
Because you're
no one
so
said
excited.
Anything.
And then
he
like keeps going, right? He's like, who the fuck made this burger? He's like, and then somebody like said like, oh, Tony made that burger. And then Chris like, where the fuck is Tony? And he's like screaming in this In-N-Out with like kids there and shit.
Yeah.
And he's like getting like all mad, all heated, and like this was in like Oregon. And he and then like Tony comes out, he's like, I just want to tell you this is a good ass burger.
Yeah.
And like Chris comes out, he's
it.
Like,
it was
and
like,
then like no one filmed
out your
it.
Pocket
I'm like,
filming,
Chris,
it's like,
why'd you do that, dude? And then like this random dude got it, but like yeah. it was just so like It was so unplanned, so bad. Like, it was just...
The scariest part is being the filmer. Like, just, like, always being there. Because, like, you don't want to be seen, right? Like, you guys film all the videos. Yeah. You don't want
to
be seen.
It's so hard to not be seen.
You guys get told to put your camera away a lot.
Yeah. You got to tuck it down.
How many how many places you guys gotten kicked out?
Oh.
Are you guys banned?
Like, how many?
How many?
I don't know.
Are you guys banned from anywhere? That's fucking nuts.
Target's
fucked. No, Target's round table? Got a round
that, table. That's a loss.
Dude, Target's fucked.
Yo, round table's good too.
Round table's super
Shout
good.
Shout out to round table, man.
That's fucked. What'd you do there?
I went around the counter and I got a drink for myself. Literally, he's like, yo, you never allowed back in.
That's damn. Berkeley and I filmed our first prank together and we got kicked out of, we were banned from Target.
The prank was literally him wearing like a fucking G-string.
But then I would bend over and tie my shoes in front of families. Yeah. And they would see like a dude wearing, okay, I was like in eighth grade and I was just trying shit, right? But like I would bend over and these families would see this kid tying his shoes and a big ass like whale tail.
Fucking whale tail G-string coming out of his pants. It was fucking funny.
It was funny, but then I was his first filmer, so I was like filming. And we got ran up, like we were like trying to get out of there.
It's fucking crazy.
They like the employees like came up to us and they're like, "Yo, you can't fucking film in here." And I was like, "Dude, what the fuck?" And me and Kai are both in the ladies section, just filming the bras and shit. And it was the most awkward fucking moment. And we got out. In middle school, and we got kicked out.
You guys are weird.
Kicked out of fucking Target. we felt weird. We were like fucking.
We were in like eighth grade.
14.
Yeah. We were like fucking seventh grade. Eighth grade.
You guys were lucky.
Like, but we were just trying shit, bro. Like, that's all it was. We were like, what sticks? What would an audience like? Yeah. I mean, were you uploading to Instagram in the very beginning, or was it YouTube first, just trying super pranks?
I was
like,
doing YouTube first. Yeah. And then
what was your first prank?
Parking ticket.
Oh. Like handing out fake parking tickets to people.
Like as they're coming to their car, so they see me like.
Yeah.
Think about like, what the fuck? Like,
did you go through this thing where like suddenly like you feel way more professional when you have a lav mic on? Do I'm talking about like the ones like, yeah, right?
But that's when it goes up. I was using earphones.
Right. But then when you put on the lav mic for the first time, you're like, oh shit, we leveled up.
Yep. Right? Yes, sir. Yeah.
Yeah.
Were you using like voice memos like in like earphones?
Yeah, exactly that. I had an iPhone 6 awesome. A year ago.
iPhone 6
Same,
a year ago.
Same, bro. Seriously. Everybody made fun of me for having an iPhone 6.
Same. Man, phone is a phone. Fucked.
Phone's a phone.
Phone's a phone.
Still some
and you could become Slim the Dream with fucking an iPhone 6.
Gotta stay consistent in strategy.
It's wild.
How do you post?
Yeah, I think it's weird, man, because I've seen your content for so long, but like now that I've met you and talked to you, I don't mean this to be like weird or anything like that, but like you come off a lot more alert and like observing of what's going on. You're a lot smarter in like you know what I mean. It's a weird thing.
It's a lot less like moaning in people's ears, right? Like
you know what's up. That's like you're not just walking around fucking around.
That's idiot Salim.
Yeah. So do you get fucked up before you go and do a prank?
No.
Like that's just sober.
I wake up 8 in the morning and go and do a prank. That's it.
Have you
literally?
It's like so. You do it really well.
He catches people in the morning. Everyone in the morning just angry as fuck.
They're so mad that some fuckhead comes and moans in their ear. But it's fucking hilarious.
Yeah.
It's like I don't know. I feel like it's you and Kyle do it really well in particular. You guys don't laugh. How the fuck do you do it without laughing? Like,
oh, I don't know.
Because he was hopping on people's Zoom calls. Like, we'd go live on TikTok, and then we'd hop on people's Zoom calls, and he was saying, like, what was he saying? Berkeley was saying, like, Dad, stop hitting me. Like,
oh, yeah, Dad. Then I came in and just trucked him.
Dad, why the fuck are you hitting me? Like, Dad, I did the laundry this morning.
Yeah.
And then, like, we'd be all be in the background just fucking cracking up. Like, it was so funny, right? Because, like, it's like a class of like 13-year-olds and like he's swearing, he's like saying like he's like drinking beer, he's like saying like he's like, Dad, why the fuck are you hitting me? Like I did my laundry already. And like
Kai just comes in and just trucks the fuck out of him.
Yeah, and then he beats the fuck out of him, like acting like his dad. Really? And then like the teacher's like, Oh my god. Like what's happening? Like she thinks it's his actual dad beating the fuck out of him. Like
you gotta
like
make sure it's college Zoom classes. You guys are fucking weird as fuck.
Wait, why?
No,
it's funny when like
we don't have enough college fans.
No, we still
low key good amount.
Hey man, stay away from my sister.
No, it was really fun.
Where'd you grow up?
I moved from San Jose to Sacramento when I was like 14.
Okay. 15,
and then I started doing pranks after my freshman year of high school.
Okay. And do your parents like our parents don't support us at all. Like unless we're making money.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. Now she knows I'm making money.
Right.
But those are parents that are like foreign. So it's like, I mean, if you
guys my parents too, the same thing.
Exactly. So if you have foreign parents, They gonna want you to be a doctor or a fucking
lawyer or a fucking
or an engineer or some shit.
Dentist. Not a YouTuber or TikToker.
Why do I want to do that? Like,
it's so much more fun. It's so much more fun doing this shit.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, it's really fun. Do they approve of, like, I mean, my parents don't love me, or any of our parents love me.
What?
Wait. They don't love me, like, swearing and shit like that, you know what I'm saying?
That's going on. That was almost a...
Dude, shout out, Mom, I love you, Mom.
Bro, who the fuck
Mom,
I love you? My parents love me, too.
Mom, I love you.
I don't know
you.
About Kai's parents.
Mom, I love you.
My mom likes me.
Shout out, fam. Okay, but my parents don't love me, like, all of us, like, swearing and shit all the time, saying whatever the fuck we want to say. For you guys, like, is it, like...
Yeah, fuck.
I mean, you're fucking bitches with a satchel on. Like, that's not... Like, that's the very opposite of a lawyer. Let me just say, okay? Let me just say.
That's a good lawyer.
That's a good lawyer. He has a satchel. Lawyers wear satchels. Yeah.
What do you keep in the satchel?
Condoms.
weed.
Darts. I shouldn't have never had it in there, but a passport.
Why would you do that, bro?
Had my social security in there.
What? Why?
Like I said, the condoms, and then I had... I remember I had one thing that was so weird that was in there. I think it was like a... Oh, I forgot what it was. I don't remember. I forgot what it was. It wasn't weird. It was AirPods, and that's it.
So how many satchels have you actually gone through? Like,
what do you mean?
Like, because Nelk dropped the satchel in the latest drop, right?
Yeah.
So I would assume that there would be more satchels, like, in the house.
There's no more.
It's just and one
my
satchel.
Last one that I had, Kyle Forgeard, lost it for me.
Did he?
To a girl with playing ping pong. Playing ping pong.
He gave it to a chick?
The satchel was bet.
Well, imagine giving away merch to a chick. Unacceptable.
Yes, and that I was very upset at that guy.
Fuck Burke.
Fuck Burke, dude. You want to hear about this?
No.
Kyle, tell
me. No. Wait, no. I want to hear more about this satchel. So the satchel, like, how did it even come to be? Where'd you find the satchel? Like, how?
Why is this?
It's been, like, the biggest. It's been a pretty big thing in Nelk.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah.
Right? It's surprising. So, what even happened? Like, how'd you get the satchel? How many kills have you got with the satchel?
I don't know.
It can't count.
I don't know.
Because in the videos, it was like, yo, Salim's going to get a satchel kill. And then it was like, next video, Salim's going to get a satchel kill. And then it just stopped because you got so many kills throughout the videos.
I don't remember. To be really honest with you. I really don't remember. It's been a lot, though.
That's sick.
It's been nice. A lot. Where'd you get the satchel from? Because the first satchel wasn't a full-send satchel, was it?
It was from...
It's like Tory Burch.
I think it was from my mom's house.
Like, it was your mom's satchel?
No, it was, like, in the house, just in there. Like, you ever have those closets?
It had history.
Oh, the random closets?
It had history
random
to
closets
it.
That just have shit
it had
in there.
History to it.
So I was like, fuck it. I mean, I was a fucking... I was a nerd in high school, kind of, in a way.
Really?
So I had a satchel. Hey, this is handy. Why not have a satchel with you?
How did people see you in high school?
This is handy.
Like, what was your how did you see yourself in, like, in the levels of high school?
Man, it was tough, man.
Because it's easy tough for you now. Like, you're on the top of what every high school wants to
do.
But, like,
I mean,
what were you in high school?
I was a kid that wore the same shoes every day.
What kind of shoes?
I was wearing, like, Converse, I think.
Okay, that's fine. Okay. Did you have, like, the weird color, like, Costco brand jacket?
No.
Or like, a raincoat? I feel like that's a classic.
It was hard to find. Bro, dude, I was a mess in high school.
I mean, what table did you sit at for lunch? Like, who are your friends? What did they do?
I would literally get lunch.
A lighter.
Okay, you want to grab something? Salim, a lighter real quick?
I want to take
a... Yeah, dude. Whew. Seriously. That's what he does.
Shit.
Fuck. All right, wait, real quick. Going back to the topic we were talking about.
High school.
High school. What's high school? What the fuck is that lighter still going?
Shit, my bad.
It's a Florida lighter. I'm telling you, it doesn't go out when you want it to.
All right, which table would you sit at in high school?
Okay, the table I would sit at. I would purposely wait to the last minute to get lunch because I didn't know where to sit.
Oh, yeah.
So I would purposely, like, wait, and then I'd be like, fuck, I'm hungry, so I'm going to just go now. And I'll just be looking around.
Did you go to middle school into, like, the same, like, town high school?
Or
did you
I went to middle school in San Jose.
Yeah, so you went to, like, the middle school in San Jose, and then you go to, like, San Jose High School?
I was going to go there, but then after that, mom wanted to move. Yeah.
Oh, you moved.
So you moved
into high school?
So we moved, moved into high school.
Oh, okay.
Bro, I'm telling you. I was lost in Sacramento.
Really? You didn't know, like, what grade? I mean, it's hard to go into fucking high school. Like,
dude, it was just, look. They were like, it's weird. It was weird. I feel like if I went to high school where I was from, I think it would have been way better. But Sacramento, it was like so, it's nothing there.
Yeah.
That's like a place you go when you're done with life. Like,
is that in like Tallahassee?
Yeah. Or like
Arizona.
Some shit in Maine or I don't know. Like, some,
yeah,
you know
what I mean? Some weird ass like crabbing town.
Or Utah.
Utah. Like, oh, yeah.
Fuck Utah.
Fuck Utah.
Fuck. Like, why be? And when I came to Sacramento, I was like,
what do you mean? The Mormons party, bro.
Jay's Mormon. Jay's, I really hope not. I feel so bad now.
Look, Jay, no. I'm a half Mormon.
So I made him cry.
Mormons are dope. Mormons are dope.
Jay, we love you.
Wait, are you actually Mormon?
Damn. Bro, that's so fucked. I feel like I'm in like the middle of a Nelk prank
right
now.
Let me say, every Mormon I've met, I've been like, we had a lot of Mormons at our high school. They were all like the chillest people.
I don't think he's actually
crazy, bro. What do you mean?
What do you mean? They were all chill.
He's no, not no, Mormon. They were man. Chill. They were no. chill. But like, dude,
Storm, no, they
he's not Mormon, right?
Okay, they partied the hardest though because they were.
Why do they party the hardest? Why
because,
do you think
because
that?
Because that was almost fucked. You remember my hard drop? Their parents were like. Their parents were like always like confining them, saying like you have to follow these rules. You can't have sex. You can't drink.
Okay, listen.
And then so they
then
said,
then we will say Muslim party hard. Then Muslims party hard.
Oh,
then.
Muslims party hard.
Yeah, they get down. But I mean, the thing, you know.
Then they go out drifting. Have you seen those videos?
They go
from like,
out, yeah.
They
have
from like
money.
Abu Dhabi
they have
and
money.
Stuff. They're fucking swinging their cars around in the middle of the freeway.
They say yeah. they don't have no. They say they don't fuck. But they do.
They fuck. Yeah.
They do. It's on another level with them. But it got to be.
You know who I like them to? Like the church leaders in like America, like the South, who are worth millions and just fuck a ton of bitches while saying like preaching to like the church and shit.
Yeah. The people you would least expect
point at
to
Jay.
Do shit. Yeah. The people you would least expect to do shit.
Yeah.
They do the most.
Oh yeah. It's always.
Like Jeff Bezos probably fucking gets his dick sucked
by
every day.
17 people in the same time.
What?
Yeah.
That's what enough. Do you mean?
I just think like I feel look. Like okay, you can get anything on Amazon, and if Jeff Bezos probably has like Amazon,
he probably
unlocked.
Has his own Amazon
with bitches.
Yes, yeah, guy's a Amazon. Creepy motherfucker.
Yeah.
Yo, we found it. We
like
found
that's Prime Plus.
It's like Amazon
look,
Fresh.
Prime this guy is not worthy. He doesn't just smile just to smile. No way.
He smiles because he's getting
he's
his
smiling,
dick wet.
Bro, yes, get his dick wet by somebody.
He's for sure.
Bro, when he goes to somewhere, bro, it's easy. It's
same
easy,
day delivery, bro.
All
they
you gotta say
up.
Is, bro,
it's
hey,
made
listen.
By Amazon Basics.
All he has to say is, I can get you whatever you want, so I own you, basically.
Oh,
that's basically what he's saying. Yeah. He's
that's
like, yo,
fucking,
I can pay for anything that you would desire, because you'll never get on my level. He's probably telling them that. He's probably a dick.
100%.
He's probably a dick, but I mean, you gotta love him.
You gotta love him.
Love
because I don't think you can run the biggest company in the world without getting your knob off.
I mean, got it. But I mean,
respect
I
the man
it's
with
weird
respect.
With him. Dude, he doesn't, bro.
He's
go
he's
to calling. One of his photos. Go to one of like a close
we just gotta analyze his face.
Wait, go to the before and after right there in the middle of the second row. 1998 and 2017.
Let's see.
Look at that.
Oh yeah, that
oh
guy looks
my
like
God.
Shit.
He fucks.
He looks like
he
Jerry fucks. Seinfeld.
He does.
In 1998.
He looks like Johnny Sins.
And then 2017,
he looks
he's
like
Vin Diesel.
Johnny Sins.
He goes from fucking Steve Carell in The Office. Look, he goes no. He goes from look, he goes from Jerry Seinfeld to Vin Diesel.
Yeah, dude.
That's what I'm saying.
The hell does he think he is in 2017? Oh, he's that motherfucker.
In 2020,
he's
fucking
that motherfucker.
Johnny Sins, dude. Yo. 2020.
Why the fuck does
you
he
might as well
smile
walk
like
around
that
naked? You might. I mean, think about it. You got the
you
most
can just
money.
Pay people to think that you weren't naked when they
exactly.
When they saw you. You're like, yo, you thought I was naked? Nah,
yo,
here's a billion.
Yo, he literally got to say, "Get the fuck off me, bitch."
Yeah, honestly,
like, there's probably bitches trying to tank, like, get him.
Is it not crazy that he could walk up to 50 people and say, "Here's a billion
Here,
dollars.
Here's $1 billion. Go
and
fuck
he would
yourself."
Still have
that's literally
another,
what he would
yeah,
say.
Yeah. And he would still
you
have
can
another.
You say those things though.
Yeah,
you're giving somebody $1 billion. I'm gonna call him a I'm gonna be like, "Yo, fuck you. Here's $1 billion."
Here's
I'll tell him that.
Oh,
like, yo,
sure.
Fuck you. Go fuck yourself. Here's $1 million.
And you just punch him in the face.
Exactly. You just sock him in the face. And then
you can actually do whatever you want.
You
then.
Can do
exactly.
whatever you
sell
want.
Their they'll use that $5,000 kids. To help their nose or whatever happened.
And the rest of you just like live life.
Exactly. You live life.
I mean, like,
live
since
life.
Moving
so don't
to
complain,
LA.
Bitch. That's, I mean, think about it.
Since moving to LA, like, we've met all these, like, okay, we've seen these chicks that do up. That, dude. It's way different. Salim, it's way different tech wise. Like, the tech chicks. LA influencer chicks.
I know you know the tech chicks.
You think I know the tech chicks? Oh,
shit. So Salim's clapping back.
Kai's into, I mean, Kai's into,
no, no, no.
Kai's into Latin America. Yeah, yeah, Latin America.
Latinos. You're into Latinas?
Yeah. If they don't have an accent. And
damn it, man.
Kai's into girls with,
for too much.
Kai's into girls with, like, super flat asses.
He's asking for too much. Bro,
girls that you're have, picky like, with, I no
feel
like, ass.
I feel like you're picky with it, though.
No, Kai's into girls with no ass.
Really?
No. It's so weird. He's like, he's yo. Boob
guys.
That boob bitch. Guy. Kai that's literally goes shopping at Home Depot, fucking goes down to the UCLA. Fucking wood section. Go to UCLA.
Your culture would be gifted there. You'll see your people.
His sister goes to UCLA.
It's like going to
his sister goes to UCLA. Pause.
No, it's like going to BSU. Bro, imagine going to a black college. Of course, you're gonna fuck the chicks there.
Yeah,
like you're gonna be comfortable fucking black. You know, I mean, for at least for me, I, dude,
I went
great.
To school in Atlanta.
But see, bro, okay, now you're lost. You gotta be. You gotta go to UCLA. That you'll your people's I there. Know, they want you there.
His sister literally goes there.
They want you there. Trust me. Then you're doing something wrong.
What you about you? Like, who do you end up like getting? Like, what's like generally the girls that you get the most?
Like blonde chicks.
Really?
I love blonde
okay,
because
I do the best.
Yeah, that's fucking lit.
Salim's like, yo, shout out.
No, shout out all the blondes.
So I do the there. Best with like South American. 100%. They're like Colombian.
Who says that?
I don't know. Me,
literally. Who says that?
I look.
Literally. It's like you saying, "Yo, I fuck."
I look at the numbers.
Kai.
You love.
You say they're brown. You know.
He loves the accents. He loves the accents. No matter what, if a girl doesn't have an accent, Kai will not go with her.
You're too picky.
He needs an accent.
A girl could just fuck us once in a while.
No. The Salim. Salim. A girl could be grinding on me.
Yeah.
But if she doesn't have at least like some, even a harsh Canadian is my limit. That's like the lowest. That's the lowest I would go. A harsh like a bruv, you know.
It's fucking shit.
Or like
a take a shot, bro.
A. Wait, what's this? What's look, the Canadian sayings? Like
There's a lot.
These boys would know it.
Listen.
Yeah.
You're too picky.
No.
You gotta stop with that. Another thing. No, I feel like you can really slam them. I feel like you're like the quiet one around these guys. You're like, hey, they don't know how much I'm fucking.
Kai just flexes clout. Hey,
you're a businessman.
No, that's actually
you guys are idiots. He knows what he's doing.
No, he knows what he's doing 100%. And like we're all vocal. Be like, yo, we're hitting blah 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 blah, hitting blah blah blah. He'll come back from a night and not tell us anything. He's like, yeah, I just had a dinner.
But then later he
tells everyone.
We already watched it happen.
Shout out Chris. He's like, hey, bro, I'm telling you, she was an 8, but she was actually like a 4. Like, you like, bro, Chris. I swam in that pussy. That's what you said. You said that one time.
Shout out Chris.
Dog, man. That's what I do sometimes too. But yeah, you're over the limit. You be going extreme, bro.
Kai waits to tell us stories until he gets like fucked up, right? Like.
Yeah.
Tell us your stories. Tell your story. What did you do? What did you do?
What did you do at Catch LA?
The break we had.
Yeah.
Let me first say, like,
the one day break.
Okay, as we've done more of these episodes, I've gone.
He takes bitches on dates. That's what he does.
No, he gets his dick sucked in Catch LA.
You got.
What?
Go ahead. Tell me, man.
Okay, every episode. Every episode we do. Like, as we've gone, like, have different guests that are, like, say more shit, every time I do it, I always think about my fucking, here we go. I always think about my fucking relatives just sitting down on the couch watching these podcasts, but fuck it. I love you. Thank you for raising me. Let's get into this. So there was this chick.
Here we go. Ben Shapiro is ready to talk.
Let's fucking go. Asian Ben
Shapiro. Let's go.
Asian, not Jewish Ben Shapiro.
What are you on, CNN? Like, come on. Let's go.
Nothing really happened, Salim.
Come on,
man.
Joe.
I mean, just like some shit went down in a fucking bathroom in Catch LA. That was it.
That's illegal.
What? How?
You can't have sex in a fucking bathroom, a public bathroom.
Why?
It's private property.
It's private property, bro.
So but if you're paying,
you
got some private pussy.
I paid $60 for a steak.
It's different,
right?
Yeah.
If I mean, it's not just like going in
for
and
cold
like,
steak too, right?
It was cold, but you put it on like a stone and it heats it up.
Oh, it's wagyu.
Wagyu. Yeah, I call it. What did I call it again?
I call it something fucking stupid.
Yeah. What did I call it?
Something fucking.
How did you get this head?
What do you mean?
The spontaneous.
Kai likes girls that make over $500,000 a year.
Yeah.
Whoa. So how did you? Well, first of all, how did you get a $500,000 chick?
So he was a part of a
political campaign.
Yeah, political.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's smart shit.
You trying to tap in, Chris?
Let's go. Do the London
accent, though. Chris, you guys watch Tim Westwood at all?
No.
You've seen Tim Westwood?
Chris can do a mad Tim Westwood.
Let's hear it.
Get in here, Chris.
Let's go.
Good shit.
Get in here.
Good shit.
Chris does this every podcast, I swear.
Here, welcome, Chris Williams. Welcome to the show. Finally.
What's up, guys? We are back on Tim Westwood Live, back in North London, ready for another podcast. You ready?
I've heard of him now. Yo, now I know who it is.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen that guy. Thing.
Yeah. He does all like the freestyles and stuff. Chris has been perfecting that for a while.
Man, dude.
And he does it. It's his go-to. He's really good at it. Like, you actually think he's Tim. Like, close your eyes and say it again.
Welcome back to. Welcome back to Tim Westwood Live. We are here in North London. We are with ASAP Rocky. You have 1 hour to freestyle.
What's up, ASAP?
We are ASAP Mob. Welcome to North London. You ready to freestyle for 1 hour?
Oh yeah, I'm that jiggy Nick.
All right, he's ready. We are firing off with the first
play
beat.
Play a beat, Luke. Go ahead, Tim Westwood. Go ahead.
Tim Westwood doesn't rap.
Can you freestyle?
Tim doesn't rap, dog. Fuck.
I'm telling you, he's good at it. He's genuinely good at it. Like, he could literally. We gotta get. What if we got Tim Westwood on the show and we had like Tim Westwood talking to Tim Westwood? Would that be Inception or what?
That'd be crazy.
That'd be sick. That'd be sick.
That's the collab of the century.
All right. It would be, right? It'd be Chris Williams.
Literally meeting his man.
Yeah. It's like, I've been watching that guy forever.
That's lit.
Every freestyle. Every single one.
Chris, what was your question you had for Salim earlier?
Yeah, okay, so I'm obviously new to like social media and stuff, but you've been doing this for a while. And there's certain pranks that it's like, obviously, like, we can't do a lot of pranks that other races can do, like, to put it like this way. Like, so how do you like go amongst yourself and be like, okay, I can do this prank, or like there's a certain prank I can't do?
I like to think of it as everyone's doing it. I don't know, in my opinion.
Yeah.
I think it's more of a just do it, you know.
Just fuck it.
I think anyone can. I don't think it's
depends on where you are, right?
It depends on where you are in a way.
Right. Like, yeah. I mean,
if you're in LA, I mean,
it's
who gives yourself a fuck? You can do what the fuck you want.
I think it's more of like, yo, if you want to do it, I mean, you're gonna do it.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, straight up, like, I wanted to do it and then I did it. You know, and it's worked out really well. I'm surprised. I mean, it's crazy how much it's grown. But yeah, it's dope.
Have you ever had like any of those instances where like you ever got like had to get like run out of somewhere?
Oh yeah,
were you listening to the podcast earlier?
No. I'm saying like,
this guy's lost.
Crazy. like, I gotta get out of here because like.
These like fans life are gonna or go death insane. Shit.
Like, yeah.
Yeah, almost.
Almost.
So. And plus, like, now we're getting recognized a lot. So anytime we go to, like, a store or whatever, or we're doing something anywhere, we're always going to get recognized. So that's going to make it seem like.
Has it made pranks difficult where you guys are getting recognized all the time? Yeah, like, I mean, because you guys have fans coming up to you and shit, right? And, like, if you guys are trying to film with someone who's, like, oblivious. Like, the thing I remember is you guys had, like, what was it called? It was the jerk me off booth. Yeah, it was like
massage. That happy ending massage.
That was
what we did is
I was in Santa Monica, right?
Yeah, what we did is we went on Craigslist and we were like, we're looking for workers, right? Like a Craigslist ass, right? So when we had this guy that came and we set up a booth, right?
Like fucking hilarious.
Yeah, so we set up a booth and he doesn't know what the fuck's going on, so we're fucking with him.
He was the perfect dude.
He was the most gullible guy.
He was the I can't think of great. A better. If I would have like thought of someone who would have been good for that prank, it would have been him. And I like, I didn't even know him. I like, you know, it's just like a dude that is wearing boots, has his, what was his name,
most gullible guy. It's like how we did the Bigfoot video, like you said. It's like finding those people. That we've been lucky with that. Like, there's a lot of people. Yeah, like
you can get like people who are just stale as fuck.
Yes,
you always get like strong people.
Of course. So yeah, that's what we did, and you know, we fucked with them to the fucking dot. It was a lot. We called him back. We're like, yo, we need you now. We're like, fuck, we're gonna just keep fucking with people and stuff. So yeah, it was crazy. That day was crazy.
How does your guys' planning go? Like mid prank, right? Because like. Obviously, I mean, if you guys are all doing your, like, it's, like, real shit, and, like, you can only plan so far.
Yeah.
So, is it just, like, the chemistry that you guys have in a team?
I know when it's, if I'm doing something with Kyle, I know when to just, like, be quiet, let him do his thing real quick. Because he's funny. Exactly. And I know when to step in those moments of, like, you got to take over now. And, like, it just, we just bounce off each other in a way.
So, do you guys have, like, so with us, it would be, like, I don't know.
That reminds of just of, that reminds of us of just, like, the way we have to plan for shit. And, like, when we're filming, we have to understand when someone's talking and who actually is on a roll. You don't want to interrupt them, right?
Yeah.
Same thing with our TikToks. It's no different. It's just, like, how to work with a team and shit like you didn't learn in school.
But theirs is, like, theirs is one take.
There's this one take. We say our shit over and over again. You guys just do one take.
I feel like that honestly kind of
was one take. We literally, that was the only person we found that guy. We were like, "Fuck, we're gonna run it tomorrow." And we literally did the whole day of fucking with him.
That was the fun. That was like top three funniest Nelk videos I've ever seen. I mean that shit was hilarious. Like I watched that twice. I literally like watched it.
Yeah, I remember the day it came out. You guys were like, oh, the new video dropped, and we all
sitting in our shitty ass studio in fucking Redmond.
So who's real now? Like who? Like back in the day, it was all the pranksters, the crazy people who go hard and shit.
I think it'd be just us.
It's just you, right?
Like, we're only doing pranks.
Yeah, because Danny Duncan isn't doing this many pranks anymore.
Yeah, he's just more of like just outlandish by himself shit, fucking
like,
around.
There's no one else that's relevant now that can like show up to a random ass like college and get mobbed. It's only you guys.
Yeah.
It used to be like what, 5 or 6 people, Vitaly would.
We go to like what happened, I don't know if you guys know what happened in Illinois, but we were not even trying to throw a party. But we just hit up some females just to hang out, and literally everyone started DMing us, and that's when everyone caught on. We literally went outside. Went in the sprinter, it's mobbed. That's and then nice. We got in trouble for that. They said that we are causing it.
Yeah. Like that, what is that like? Because I know about the stuff that happened at the old like Jersey Shore house. That seems like it's just people know you're there, so they're going to mob. It's the same thing if Justin Bieber showed up at some random-ass mall. You know what I mean? It's not your fault, but you end up getting blamed for it, which is kind of fucked.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty much
it. It's also fucked because it's not teenage girls. It's like, you know, 18 to 24-year-old dudes, right? Like, that, like, are pulling
up. Yeah, and like kids, too, sometimes. Crazy. Like, 17, 16-year-olds sometimes. Lowest is probably 16, I'd say.
How long does it take to, like, scramble out of there? Like, out of a huge mob, like, in a car?
We leave before it even happens. It probably happened only a couple times where we're like, fuck, this is too much.
Yeah.
We're in Orlando. We're literally leaving out the place, and they're surrounding our spinner.
Fuck. So what's next? International, like get big ass, like biggest fucking, like
they're coming up.
Everyone
uni.
Wow.
That's what they call it, right?
No, on their wine, on like their wine tour through fucking, what was that, through Italy?
Yeah,
like yeah, you guys are getting recognized there and shit.
Yeah, I wasn't there for that part, but yeah, they must have fucking, yeah,
that's well, greasy.
It's universal content, like even like all around the globe, everybody can enjoy the pranks. Like it's not one specific country, I guess. Like how other YouTubers are.
I mean, like, you know Wave House? Like there's a content house in England, right? Like what Chris is saying.
I heard about that.
But like they all look at America, what Los Angeles is, like the people making content here as like the big shit. Like that's the goal. You build shit in UK to become what it is now here. Like that's what you're doing in your own fucking. It's so weird that we're doing that in this world, especially when you see like the international houses, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, I'm not in the TikTok world, but I can see how it is for them.
YouTube too, bro. Like you guys are number one YouTube.
Yeah, YouTube.
Yeah.
YouTube, yeah.
It's everything. It's all the same. YouTube, Instagram, it's all the same.
Yeah, well, I mean there's a lot of people we look up to YouTube wise. That's like really good, but I feel like now we're like surpassed all that.
Who are you looking up to?
Well, we used to look up to like Vitaly and
really?
And yeah, pranksters before. Wow, bad. Well, for me and probably for Kyle and Jesse.
Do you guys get that you guys are like bigger than they ever were? Yeah. They were the best. They pioneered all those
pranks. We are like
you are big
mainstream, I think now.
Everyone
knows. Like if I go to a mall, everyone's gonna know.
It's like how everyone wears like Teddy Fresh or like Danny Duncan merch. They wear your merch. Full Send merch is casual clothing. That's full when you become big on YouTube.
That's a whole different. I think
Full Send has become bigger than us. Nelk.
Yeah,
for sure. Yeah. Well, because there's people that just buy Full Send merch that don't even.
They don't even know us. They don't even watch us. So it's like shit like that. That's what's mind blowing to me. I didn't think it was gonna be like this.
Yeah. How many people were on your last drop? Like how many people were on the site?
They said it was 320 plus.
320,000 people.
And I don't know if you can discuss how many things do you guys actually sell.
it sells out.
Yeah, but like, but how many, so like, how many total items are on?
I don't know. That's a lot.
It's quite a bit.
It's a lot. It's like, I didn't even know how much my Rafiki merch, how much we sold for the shirts, but it was a lot.
So in Hype House, like, if you sell merch that's like made for you, like the way the Rafiki is made for you, like people use like hashtag Tony Lopez or something like shit like that, right? They make more percentage off that. Is that like the same for you?
Or for well, it's kind of complicated with mines, but I don't know. It's everything that we do is always collaborative, and everyone's just coming in, and we're just this whole, we're trying to get full send to number one. That's all our mindset.
It has to be close, right?
Yeah.
I mean, who's, I mean, like, what, behind, like, Supreme? Like, I mean.
We want to get to, like.
Supreme level.
I mean, it has to be super close. I mean, like, what, like what else?
I think we compete with Supreme. I don't know. Oh, for sure. I don't know.
I think so.
If you have 320,000 people on your website, yes, I mean, compete with Supreme.
Spencer's in the Supreme. He's in the full set. Like, I mean.
He's into both of your drops.
Like, I mean, that'd be close, right?
Hello. You guys sell out faster than Supreme. No, they probably have the same inventory.
So fast.
And I feel like
it's fire too.
It all comes from the videos. So that's the hardest part.
Well, because it's kind of hard, like, because like you guys aren't. It's weird you guys aren't making money off YouTube, but I guess YouTube just, it was all the Google prank. Google prank.
So you guys like showed up at YouTube, and that probably fucked you monetization wise.
Yeah. Kyle and Jesse showed up at Google, and they were crashing bikes into people and shit. And like,
and that's
Google,
funny. Though.
And Google didn't take it too well.
Yeah,
Google
was fucking known.
Like, and then you guys got banned for like 3 months or so. Yeah, it was fucked.
Yeah, man, it was crazy back then for them.
Yeah, they must have been. They've been through some stuff.
I mean, if you guys are making off, if you did get monetized every single video, if you're getting 6 million per video, you're making about 12 grand per video, 4 videos a month, you're making 48 grand a month on videos, and probably in a Google preferred you'd be at like 70k a month.
That's crazy.
That is what, 70k times 12, what is that? That's like 960. So that's like, dude,
it's almost $1 million a year.
That's about $1 million. That's $960,000 a year.
Yeah,
fuck.
That's all to think about.
That's so many views.
Are you guys thinking of staying independent, or like, are there any like talks of streaming services or like television shows like in the future?
Jackass style.
Just doing our own thing.
Yeah. I feel like you guys are kind of paving. A new path.
We have the views. Why switch over?
Right.
Like, we're already made. I mean, I think everyone knows us now. They've at least seen us.
Yeah.
Everyone has. Yeah.
If any of us go to a college campus, it's over.
It's over.
It's over.
Everyone's there.
Everyone's going to know.
That's the dream.
As soon as one guy, I'll tell you the exact description. It is, it's basically him.
Him?
You see a guy like him or him, or a guy with a backwards hat, blonde hair, got shorts, got a white t-shirt. Yeah, exactly. You guys. If you seen me at a campus.
Oh, like someone like him at a campus.
At a campus.
Like some frat dude.
You walk by, you'll know who's a fan.
Yeah.
You'll just know. Even if they're not even looking at you, you'll know who's a fan if you walk past them.
And then you know that once they see you, like, they're going to recognize you right away. So you see like one of the fucking frat moves, like Kyle and Burke, like, oh, those guys turn around, they know full send.
Yep.
Yeah, that's sick. I don't think we have
it. You knew us.
We don't have an understanding like that. We don't know what our audience exactly looks like, but you do.
We know.
That's an advantage, bro. We don't know.
When they have, I mean, there's fucking 5 million of them. I mean,
that's true. You have 5 million people.
Insane number. It's just like they have such a better idea of who it is. Like, we have a lot of 13-year-old fucking kids.
But we also have a lot of college students too. It's a mix.
I would love to start
doing stuff that's more like,
right,
drinking on, like, you know, talking honestly, about fuck shit, you know.
But like, we need some money coming in from brand deals. If we had the brand deals and they fucked with us, we would drink. We would get fucking like blasted on this episode.
For me, I didn't really care about money when I first started, and I was like, fuck it, I don't care.
But like, we have 8 people. We need to pay rent. That's the thing. Like, bro, we need a house to live in.
They have 29 fucking people.
Okay, yeah, but we need to pay rent next month, bro. That's what it is.
Yeah. Well, yeah. When you think of it that way, then yeah, you probably have to. I mean, for me, when I was doing it, I wasn't making money. I stayed with a fan for like a year.
At his house?
Yeah.
Fuck.
He was like, never left.
No, he told me, it was like, kind of like a family. It was like a mom and a son, and two sons. And they were like, yo, stay in. Like, they loved my shit.
Good. Damn, that's sick.
They loved my shit. This was before Nelk, though.
They made it happen for you, like, to get you to the point where you could join Nelk later.
Yeah, yeah. They helped a lot.
Have we had anyone like that, Kyle?
You used to be like that. You got kicked out of your fucking house.
That's true. I used to get kicked out all the time.
Yeah, we used to fucking harbor Kai at his...
my dad and I were getting huge arguments, and I have to leave the house.
Yeah, I literally moved to L.A., literally drove, stayed in, like, cars and stuff,
yeah.
And then went to this guy's house for a year. And then that's when Kyle hit me up after, like, 5-6 months, almost.
So was Jay editing for you?
No, I edit all of mine. He just films my pranks.
Okay, so you guys were, like, living, like, together, right?
Yeah, in, like, car and then, like, at that place that we were living at.
So, and then were you guys, like, a package deal for coming in? Because he would film for Nelk, right?
Yeah, he was filming for me. And then once we went on Nelk, that's when he started filming for them and me. So, yeah. Basically, I guess so.
Hell, yeah. I really fuck with Cousin Jay. Like, the Crocs and shit and the blue sweatpants. That's my guy.
Yeah. So, yeah. That's what happened.
Kai's still happy right now.
I am. I think this is sick. It's what we've been working on for the last 6 months, bro. Get to this point. We're going to have people on that we fuck with. Exactly. Before, like, we were, like, talking about having our high school teachers on, which we've had some funny as high school teachers, but this is a different story.
Definitely a whole different story.
What's crazy is, like, before coming here, we made a list of the podcast, like, guests that we would likely, like, want to have on this show, and your name was on there, and, like, we were just like, we don't know if he's going to come on. Like, obviously, Nelk's built, like, big as fuck now, so, like, we didn't know if you'd answer him, like, now, months later.
LA's different, bro. It's a different beast. Like, you meet people.
I feel like you're still, like, the same dude, though. I don't think the fame has gotten to you. I feel like
you're chilling, man.
Yeah.
LA's toxic, bro. I heard from everyone here.
The women is toxic. The streets, everything. It's toxic here.
Good thing we don't leave the house at all.
Yeah. I want to get cuffed up out here.
Oh, yeah? You don't want to get cuffed up out here?
No, I'm saying get cuffed up from another chick that's probably from, like, Alabama or some shit.
Why Alabama?
Because you don't want them from California.
You want someone from the South, though?
Somewhere else. Just South anywhere, Dakota,
anywhere.
Wherever.
Anywhere.
Utah?
Yeah, probably. Okay. That's even the bet. That's better. Okay. So, yeah.
Someone, like, settle who doesn't, like, party too much.
Settle and then live with her. Or, no, have her live with you or something. Move here with her.
Fuck.
That's better.
That's the way to go. Damn.
Dude, you can't find a girlfriend out here. It's too hard.
They know you think it's impossible to find a girlfriend out here?
Bro, before Nelk, bro, you don't understand.
It was impossible?
Dude, it was hard out here.
Okay, but, like,
it was hard.
How much did Nelk help you?
Like, percentage? Oh, yeah. Two.
Two. Different game.
Oh, man. Crazy.
Really? Like, every chick?
It's lit.
I feel like it's any. Like, you're at that point where it's just like any girl, right?
No, I wouldn't say that necessarily.
But how many followers before it turned?
I was at 500K.
Once you hit 500K, you're like, I need chick. Not every chick, but a lot of chicks.
Instagram, you have to have a verification.
Yeah. That blue check means.
We're working to get verified on TikTok in the next couple of days, bro.
You got to try to.
I know. Then Instagram's a big one.
Instagram is very hard to
get. What about the editors, though, bro? Like, do you guys get it? Like, do you guys get a lot of, like, chicks from being with Nelk and working with?
Oh, don't lie. Yes,
the editors get more chicks.
The editors have. There we go. Yeah, Jack Linsky's brother, bro.
No.
Nelk takes care of their boys. That's what I'm saying. This guy's a dirty demon, bro. Trust me. This guy's fucked.
Yeah,
I'm telling you.
He's over there sipping on a gallon of water.
He's not as nice as you think.
He's about to go put some work in later.
Oh.
What's the party you guys are going to?
Where are we going?
Gonna get a little athletic.
Yeah? Are you being serious or you lying?
Versatile. That's the newest Nelk word.
Yeah.
Versatile. That one got implemented a few videos ago.
You get versatile in
versatile
there.
Is getting crazy.
You got to fill a tank.
Damn. How many parties are happening a week? What's the ratio there, like, per week?
For what?
Like, just, like, fucking ragers going on in LA, like, among influencers.
It's every day. I don't go every day, but it's every day.
How many do you get invites every single day?
Not every day. Probably sometimes, like, Wednesdays or Fridays.
Wednesday's a weird Wednesday?
Wednesdays, Fridays, sometimes, yeah.
Damn, I didn't think Wednesday. Party
on Wednesdays.
There's something going on every day.
Because, like, you don't think that there'd be something happening at night, so, like, it never gets
work here quickly. It's like a hump day.
Dude, something every day. Damn. Simple. It's LA. What do you expect?
I don't know.
LA's. We've only been here for a week.
We have.
We've only been here for a week.
Are you serious?
Yeah, a week.
Damn, dude. You guys are.
We had a crazy first week, though.
Crazy first week.
Kind of get a first week.
Who slammed? You, I know.
Chris fucked.
And what about you?
Nah. Not this week.
What's up with you, man?
Dude. You got
Clubhouse, though. Yeah, you're a jock.
Yeah, get the fuck out of here, Berkeley.
You had to.
I didn't slam this week.
You're like Ryan Gosling, bro.
Kind of Ryan Gosling. That's a compliment.
People say he looks different. Like Cody Ko.
You look like his brother.
People
tell
me Cody Ko. I get Cody Ko a lot.
I can see Cody Ko.
David Spade. David Spade.
Oh, you look like fucking...
Pull up David Spade again.
Fat fucking fat ass.
Pull up David Spade, Luke.
Fucking fat ass.
That's...
Go fucking work out, you pussy.
Burke fucks hot chicks, though, so it's okay. I got your back,
bro. Get the fuck out of here.
Berkeley's cuffed, bro. That shit's so dumb.
He's not cuffed in LA. He's like leashed, and that's like sometimes
the
you get
the day I look like fucking 5'2" David Spade is a crazy
is that
day.
Not you think Kyle he's an attractive Beale. Guy?
No. I mean, I think he's funny. Is that not Kyle? Go look at it. Come on. I don't think it's a bad thing.
You
at
look
all.
Like Ryan Gosling.
Thank you.
Stretched
see,
out.
Ryan Gosling's like way
that
better.
Is way better. True.
It's Ryan Gosling, but his face is kind of stretched out. Like
my face?
Yeah, yours is like a stretched out version. Because look at his face; it's all like ooh. Like,
yeah, Ryan Gosling's very Hollywood.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think many people compare to Ryan Gosling.
You kind of look like Salim the Dream. I don't know if you've heard of him.
Yeah, he's
like this dude. He's like in Nelk and shit.
It's
I don't
weird.
Know.
Dude. He moans in people's ears and shit, dog.
Man. Come on,
he
man.
Like wears like a satchel sometimes.
You know, they used to call me, like, everyone knows this in our fan base. Like, I used to be like 220 pounds. They called me Russell from Up.
Fat as fuck. Is that not tough?
Is that not tough?
Look up, look up Russell from Up right now.
No, wait, no. Look at my Instagram and see the pictures I'm tagged in. That's
what that was tough. That was a
were
tough
you getting
time.
A's in high school?
No.
What's going on?
No, Kai's ankles were just hurting normal. All the time, dude. He is carrying around 220
pounds. So what was going on in high school? Were you smart at all?
I mean, I did hard classes, but I didn't do well. That's what I'm saying.
He could have done well, though.
He could have. He didn't.
No, I didn't have that Asian gene. So, like, my last name's Watson, bro. I got the fuck part of the gene where I don't have the smart part, bro.
Let's see.
Tag, go all the way down to Han's post, all the way down. I got a lot of like, random-ass posts of me.
That was my baby, Christina.
You and your mama.
All right, keep on going down. Keep on going down.
That's as far as it goes.
No. It's loading right there, bro.
Oh, shit. All
right, hurry up and load, bro. Hurry up and load. Yeah, dude, I was 220 pounds. And they call me Russell from Up. How fucked is that?
Hey, man. Well, let me see if you look like him.
It's not loading.
All right, let me show you my phone real quick, I guess. Because this is actually, like, funny as fuck. This is like Cliff Averill, bro. He's
bro, that's
like
me.
A,
how the fuck did I make it in this photo?
That's you?
That's yeah. Kyle right there.
That's me.
You look different, bro.
That was pre-beard.
Alright, this is me right here. Luke, I'll send you this picture after.
That's our that's our friend Walker who's in a rap.
Damn. Room. That's wild. You did a lot. You changed.
No.
This guy changed.
I wanted
Kai went off. He got fit. He went off.
I don't know. We've been watching for a while. We thought like a big moment in all the podcasts we filmed is like when we get like you on, anyone on, Kyle on. We fuck with you. It's been crazy. It's been a great episode, Kyle.
Are you crying right now?
I'm crying, bro, because I'm happy, bro.
Kai.
All I'm saying is, bro, like people live one life.
Why are you crying?
Okay, that's just because I have my contacts in.
You're wearing glasses.
This has been a sick episode. That's all I'm saying, okay? So it's been a great episode. Salim, thank you for coming on.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for having me.
Did you enjoy the podcast?
Oh, yeah. I had a good time.
That's what I'm talking about. It was
good. Good.
I think we just ran for like an hour 30.
Really?
Yeah. That was a long podcast.
What time is it? It's 10:05. We started at what, 8?
Yeah.
Shit.
Fuck. Alright, it's been a great episode. Make sure to subscribe. Real quick, Kyle, do you want to read out an audience review?
What's audience review?
In like no
we have like we, our know. Podcast is on Apple Music and Spotify, so we read the reviews with the stars.
We have 5 stars on Apple Podcasts and Spotify. Thank you, we appreciate it, Salim. What your Instagram?
Okay, I'm gonna close this shit out. Hey, thank you Salim, so much for coming on. You fucking killed it. It's been a great episode, one of my favorites. Kai, I don't know what the fuck Kai's up to.
Are you crying, bro?
Subscribe to
my eyes got dry as fucking the light. My eyes get
no,
dry.
No, shut the subscribe to us on YouTube. Buy some fucking merch. Follow us on Instagram. Follow Salim on Instagram. Follow him on YouTube. Follow Nelk.
All link down below.
All be down below.
Let's go.
Kyle, Cop Nelk's next merch drop in like 2 months. Coming out. It's gonna be some heat.
Any message to the fans, Salim?
Rep the send.
Rep the send.
Love you guys. I'm stoned. Fucks up.
You faced two fucking joints on that.
Yeah, I'm done. No, I'll be good. I'll be good in an hour.
We'll see you guys next time.
Trailer game,
baby.
Peace out. Peace out.